Hello and welcome to the Monsoon Safety Awareness Week series presented by the National Weather Service and Flagstaff. Today's topic is flash flood safety. Did you know that floods are the leading cause of death among thunderstorm-related hazards in the U.S.? And did you know over 90% of those deaths occurred in flash floods? It's true, but it's highly preventable. Hopefully this video will help you be prepared in the event a flash flood affects you, as well as encourage you to make the right choices to avoid danger. Flash flooding is especially common in the Southwest, as dry desert soils don't absorb heavy rainfall very efficiently, and the region is covered with narrow canyons and dry washes that are highly susceptible to floods. These canyons and washes can quickly turn into raging rivers in the event of a flash flood. Take a look at these pictures of the normally busy recreational hotspot of Slide Rock State Park near Sedona, contrasted with the flash flood taken in the same location. As you can see, the floodwaters can be very dangerous, with canyons and creek beds such as this one being very sensitive to heavy rainfall. So is it a good idea to set up a campsite in a dry creek bed or base of a canyon? Well, hopefully you answered no, that is not a good idea, and a common cause of death and injury among recreationalists. The leading cause of death and injury among flash floods, however, does not come from campers or outdoor enthusiasts. It comes from drivers. More than half of the flash flood-related deaths come from people trapped in their vehicles. Did you know it takes as little as 2 feet of flowing water to sweep your car away? And the force of the current is not always obvious, which is why you should never try to cross flooded roadways. The water may be deeper than it appears, or the road could be washed out beneath you. Every year, motorists across the Southwest take unnecessary risk, so just remember our motto, turn around, don't drown. So let's conclude this video with some basic terminology every resident in the Southwest should be familiar with. What's the difference between a watch, a warning, and an advisory? Starting with a flash flood watch, this means conditions are favorable for flash floods, but one is not currently occurring. When a flash flood watch is issued, be aware of enhanced flood potential, especially near canyons, washes, and recent burn areas. Keep an eye to the sky and listen for possible warnings or advisories if they are issued. A flash flood warning means a flash flood is occurring or is imminent. This is your time to take action. Seek higher ground immediately and never drive through flooded roadways or normally shallow creek beds. Don't play or linger near flood areas and listen to the NOAA Weather Radio or visit our website for flooding details. Also, remember it does not have to be raining over your head to have a flash flood. Water flowing downstream can flood areas far away from the parent thunderstorm. Finally, a flood advisory means heavy rainfall has caused urban areas or small streams to experience minor flooding. While the situation may not be particularly life-threatening, floodwaters can still be dangerous. Exercise caution near flood zones and take action by moving to safety if necessary. Stay tuned for tomorrow's topic of lightning safety, and be sure to find us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Thanks for watching.